What you want? Welcome to the Horizon Newscast for the week of December 3rd, 2012. I'm producer Bella Portero. There's no place like home for the holidays. Some IU Southeast students refer to the lodges as their home away from home during the holiday season. Kimberly Bottoms talked to some of those students staying on campus.
Approximately 400 students live on the IU Southeast campus within the five lodges. Living on a college campus is exciting, but if left behind during the holidays, what's it really like? I made a visit to IU Southeast lodges and talked to students and faculty. Natalie Oliver said she will be staying on campus during the Thanksgiving holiday because her family really cannot afford for her to travel back and forth.
I will probably be staying on campus for Thanksgiving.
Okay.
We don't really have enough money to get me back and forth, and I just got a job, so I'll probably just...
Some students stay behind to try and land a job for the holidays. Nick Brighton, an Orchard Lodge resident, said he will be spending most of his time job hunting.
I think I will be here quite a bit, though, during the holidays, because, you know, more than anything, I'm going to be trying to get a new job around here. So, you know, with interviews and stuff coming up, I feel like it'd be really good to be here.
Metal Lodge resident Briston Odom welcomes the idea of staying behind versus visiting home and missing family.
I mean, I've been seeing the same family members since I'm 20, so 20 years I've seen them, they're the same people, so, you know, I can bear a year without seeing them on holidays. And then we got plenty more Christmas. And
the lodges do remain open during winter break, but students are strongly encouraged to go off campus during the holidays for a mental break and to get rejuvenated for spring semester. Amanda Stonecipher said what some of the benefits are for students to take a break from campus life.
But we do allow our students to stay, and we do have lower occupancy during that time because a lot of students do choose to go home. So our office still remains open, so we encourage students to reach out to us. We don't have anything planned during that December 17th through January 3rd. We don't have anything planned during that time, but a lot of our community advisors plan events right before finals and during finals week to help our students have some stress relief. And then in January, we have events when they come back to welcome them back to campus.
Kimberly Bottoms with the Horizon Newscast.
No matter where you are spending this holiday season, on behalf of the Horizon Newscast, stay happy, healthy, and safe. The day after Thanksgiving, also known as Black Friday, has become a holiday all on its own, where people line up for days and hours to get great deals. Kate Smith has more on Black Friday.
Just moments after having given thanks for what they already have, people line up for hours to catch the great deals on Black Friday. Alicia Barnacle, psychology senior, said she saw chaos during her Black Friday shopping experience.
People fighting and getting kicked out, pushing, screaming, you name it.
Many people stood in line for hours and even days, but Genesee McConnell, an elementary education senior, faced the lines and told us who she was buying for this holiday season.
Probably a little bit of both. I mean, if I see something for my family, then I'll probably pick it up and grab it for Christmas and stuff like that.
For those of you that are not brave enough to face the Black Friday crowd, there's still time to get your loved ones gifts for the holiday season. From the Walmart in Cordon, I'm Kate Smith, the Horizon Newscast.
According to Orlando Business Journal, a record-breaking 247 million people shopped in stores or online this Black Friday. Most people are familiar with IU Southeast as a business and education university. However, Sandra Morris exposed the more artistic side of the curriculum available when she attended the senior art show before the Thanksgiving break.
We talked to IUS students at the senior art show held at the River City Winery in downtown New Albany.
J.N.O. Bear Public Hall is on the second floor of the River City Winery and was rented to house the one-night-only IUS senior art show, Pencils, Pixels, and Prints.
And I've seen just fantastic, super cool, colorful work
all around the arts and letters school, lobbies, walls, and in the gallery. So I really wanted to see what the students had. And I've seen those really cool postcards advertising it as well. So all those things pulled me over here tonight.
Most of the senior artists who participated in the show had never been in a public venue. They worked since the beginning of the semester to pull off this event.
It's really my first show, so it's kind of an overwhelming experience, but it's pretty exciting. I mean, a lot more people came out than we expected, and the space seemed really big, but now it seems really small.
Some of the participants seemed surprised by their own involvement in the show. Nevertheless, the space had the look and feel of a professional art gallery.
I love it. It's great. All the artwork looks great. The space actually looks like gallery space. Like, we did so much work to get this ready. And, like, everybody was here and we all pitched in, and great turnout. So, you know, I couldn't really want much more.
All of the works displayed were for sale, but according to one participant we spoke with, making a sale wasn't the best thing she got out of the show.
I just think it's awesome just to overhear people saying, hey, I really like your work, or that piece over there makes me feel like this, and, you know, it's just stuff like that is just warming to the heart.
From the River City Winery in downtown New Albany, this is Sandra Morris with the Horizon Newscast.
If you are undecided about your major and catch yourself dabbling or doodling, maybe art is for you. To find out more about possibilities of an art major, visit ius.edu/finearts. IU Southeast took on Mid-Continent before Thanksgiving break. Mark Mullins was there to catch some action.
IU Southeast took on Mid-Continent University in hopes of improving their records to 3-2. It was a close game, though the Grenadiers pulled out a win 76-74. Head coach Wiley Brown was concerned with how the team was playing overall.
We continue to play and play hard, but it's just in spurts where you can't, in crucial situations, like when they made their run, then we kept turning the ball over, or we didn't get a rebound, and they scored. The whole time we gotta stop.
Tyrell Means felt better about the game than Coach Brown, but agreed that the team as a whole had things to work on.
I feel good about the game. I mean, we still got a lot to work on, but the biggest thing is that we're starting to play as a team. But we still got work on our defense. It's not really a team we're looking forward to playing. It's whoever comes up next.
From the Activities Building, I'm Mark Mullins, the Horizon Newscast.
For more information on IU Southeast teams and game schedules, visit the website at iusathletics.com. With more than 40 optional majors at IU Southeast, it's obvious that there's a long list of classes available. But are you interested in something that's not offered at IU Southeast? Leah Armfield tells us how you can expand your degree with MetroVersity program.
The University of Louisville is part of the MetroVersity program, in which IU Southeast students can take advantage of.
IU Southeast is a member of Kentuckiana MetroVersity, a group of institutions of higher education in the Louisville metro area. MetroVersity rules states that a full-time undergraduate student may register for a maximum of 8 credit hours during the fall or spring semesters at one of the member schools. Full-time graduate students may take up to 4 credit hours at another member school.
You have to be a student in good standing, which means you have to have a 2.0 GPA or greater GPA, and you have to be enrolled in a full-time, which is 12 hours or more. And that can include your classes at IUS and your classes through the Metro University.
In addition to the University of Louisville, Bellarmine College, Jefferson Community College, Louisville Presbyterian Theological Seminary, Southern Baptist Theological Seminary, and Spalding University are all schools that make up the MetroVersity group.
You have to go and have a form signed by your advisor and the dean, and you do that so that they're saying and agreeing that when you take this class, when it comes back, it is going to count towards your degree. It's going to be something that you can use. And then you have to have it signed by the registrar just as a formality, and then we set up a pseudo course here at IUS so that after you complete the course at whatever other institution you take it at, you get a grade, so that grade comes in, it's put on that pseudo course.
MetroVersity forms are available from the registrar's office at the home institution. Permission must be obtained from the home and host registrars before any full-time student may cross-register.
From the University of Louisville campus, Leah Armfield, the Horizon Newscast.
For more information on how you can sign up for Metroversity, visit ius.edu and type in Metroversity in the search bar. The registrar's office will start collecting forms Monday, December 3rd. Now here's a look at the upcoming events with Leah Armfield.
Stress-free zones, Monday, December 3rd through Thursday, December 6th, in the Commons in University Center North. Are finals stressing you out? Come relax in the Commons with SPC. There are different events each day of the week before finals, which will help you relax and become more focused as finals arrive. Men's basketball, Saturday, December 8th, 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. in the Activities Building. The 11th-ranked Grenadiers will host the Spalding Golden Eagles. Jingle Hop Santa Shop, Sunday, December 9th, 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. in the Hoosier Room, University Center North. Take some time out with your children and head over to the Jingle Hop for some holiday fun and crafts. Santa and his elves will be rocking around and visiting with the little kids and big kids alike. RSVPs are mandatory by Thursday, December 6th at 5 p.m. Please contact Kim Pell at 812-941-2650 to save your place. Rental book returns. All returns are due by Monday, December 17th, 2012. Official grades available on OneStart, Thursday, December 20th. Go to OneStart, log in, click Student Center, and then click on My Academics and Grades. Spring semester starts January 7th, 2013. All applications are due by December 31st, 2012.
As always, thanks for watching the Horizon Newscast. Being a producer this semester has been a rewarding experience. The memories and friends that I have made will last a lifetime. I'm proud to have been a part of the Horizon, and I'm excited to see the new direction they are taking next semester. Again, have a fun and safe winter break. Stay classy, Grenadiers. Bye!
She pulls her hair back, turns around and starts to laugh, lending her eyes to all who pass. So my baby gets it anyway. When she does me wrong, I start to scream, but my baby sure knows how to sing, and I forget about everything. Oh, my baby.